Hey kiddos, I'm so excited that we are setting up our Google Classroom today. But before we set up our Google Classroom, we have to set up our email. So this is what I'm gonna ask you to do for me first. You're gonna open your laptop, okay? The laptop that the school has given you is what I would prefer for you to be working on, okay? You're gonna come all the way down to the bottom of your bar. It may be over here on the side. This is the same laptop that you were using last year if you were with us last year. And so just go find Safari and open it. If you have Google Chrome, which this is right here, it's the green, yellow, and red one. That's what I would prefer for you to click on. If you don't have it, it's not a big deal. So go ahead, you're going to open your internet, and up at the top, you're going to type in gmail.com, gmail.com, and then you're going to hit enter, and it's going to take you to where we're going to sign into our email, okay? Now, I've already signed into my emails before, and again, if you're on the same laptop that you were on last year, hopefully it already has your stuff saved. But if you don't see your name there, if it doesn't have your email, you're gonna come down here and you're going to use another account, or it may even say add account. So if I say use another account, I'm going to type in my email address. Now kiddos, your email address is very, very simple. So my name is Megan Griffin. So my email address is gonna be my first name, which is Megan, my last name, which is Griffin, @crosscountyschools.com. This is what your email address needs to look like. Okay. So if your name is Susie, you're going to type in Susie. If your last name is Jackson.Jackson, Susie.Jackson@crosscountyschools.com. That's your email address. Okay, kiddos, once you have your email typed in, you're going to want to come in and type in your password. Now, your teacher has sent you your password, okay? It's going to be different for everybody. So remember, be looking for that message that came with this video that's going to tell you your email password. Once you get that typed in, if Ms. Megan could type, okay, you're going to hit next and now. Okay, now that you're logged into your email, that's all I needed you to do. It was just like that. Up here in the tab where you're going to search, you're going to type in classroom.google.com. Okay, classroom.google.com. That's where I would like for you. Once you get signed in with your email, you may see old Google Classrooms pop up. If you've never had a Google Classroom before, that's okay. You're going to go right over here to this plus sign, and that's where you're going to be able to join a class. Okay, don't hit create a class, hit join class. It's going to ask you for a class code. Now, everybody's class code is going to be different. Okay, so your teacher is going to send you a class code, probably in a remind message. Okay, so make sure that you're looking for that. But once you get that class code, you're just going to type it right there in the box, and be careful that you type it in exactly the way it looks, because otherwise it won't let you in. So once you get your class code in, let me just check mine. Okay, you're going to hit this button down here that says join. It may take a second to load, but that means it's working, right? That's a good thing. Boom. Okay, so now I'm in Miss Catherine's kindergarten class. Isn't that exciting? Okay, so here we go. If I'm a student in Miss Catherine's class, I'm going to have a stream, and as Miss Catherine posts more assignments, I'm going to have more to click on. But here we go. Let's say that this is the very first assignment that Miss Catherine wants me to do. I'm going to click on it. Taking a second to load. Give it just a second. Okie dokie. So here we go. Here's the assignment. Now, do you see where it says class comments right there? That is the spot where I am going to be able to, if I have a question, I can ask my teacher. So I could say, hey, Miss Catherine, I am having trouble with my assignment. Okay. Well, if Miss Megan could spell, this would go easier. There we go. Okay. Hey, Miss Catherine, I'm having trouble with my assignment. Okie dokie. If I am struggling, I have a question, I can type that in there. I can click that little paper airplane button, and boom, it's going to post, and Miss Catherine's going to be able to see it. So next time I click on this assignment, her words are going to be right there. And Miss Catherine and I can go back and forth and have an entire conversation. Now, to see my work over here, you're gonna see over to the right side of your screen, anything that you have to click on and complete. So Miss Catherine's given me an assignment here. I have to click on that, okay? Once I click on it, I'm gonna do whatever the instructions tell me to do, okay? I'm gonna work on it. I can click on this and type on it, okay? And get all of my work done right here on this slide. Now, let's say I'm all done. I've done all of my work. I did it just right. I'm really proud of it. I'm really excited. It's my best work and I'm ready to turn it in. I'm gonna go, excuse me. If you look up top here, I can click back and forth on my tabs up here at the top. So this is my work. But remember, I was in Miss Catherine's classroom, so I can click right there. If I'm all done with it, there's this button right here, right, where I can click turn in. So that's gonna be the button that I click to turn in my assignment. Okay, so now it's turned in. If I wanna get it back, maybe I messed something up and I need to fix it, I click this little button right here that says unsubmit. It's gonna give it back to me and let me keep working on it. So, done my work. If I wanna go back to Miss Cat's room, I can click on her Google Classroom right here. And maybe I wanna look at just my classwork, okay? Right here, it's gonna say view your work, and that's where I can track my progress, and I can see, do I have any missing assignments? Have I done all of my work for that day? Do I have a grade on that work yet? Okay, so I'm gonna be able to click on it, and boom. Let's say that this was due yesterday, and oh no, I forgot to do it. In big red letters right here, it's gonna say missing, and that tells me I need to do it really quickly, okay? Or if Miss Catherine has already graded my work, I can click on it and it's gonna tell me I got a 100 out of 100. Or maybe I didn't do my best work and I got a 70 out of 100, right? So make sure you're always doing your best work because we are going to be grading it. So here, if I click view my work, here's my assignment. I've turned it in, I'm not missing it. I can, if I was worried about my missing work, I can go over here and click missing. And it's gonna tell me my missing work. If Miss Catherine's turned back work into me, I can click on returned and see that. Or if Miss Catherine's just given me an assignment, I can click assigned, okay? Now I'll show you how to get to that again. I'm gonna hit classwork, view your work, and then I can see everything that I need to know. If I'm missing something, if what grade I got on something, all of that good stuff, okay? Okie dokie, kiddos. So there you have it. That's exactly how you're going to use Google Classroom. If you have any questions, ask your teacher, okay? They are there to help you. I can't wait to see all the great work that you guys do this year, and I'm so excited that you've decided to come learn with us. See you guys later.